Nearly half a century since its launch, NASA's most traveled spacecraft, the Voyager 1, is continuing its journey into the uncharted territories of our universe. However, there seems to be a glitch in this iconic space probe machine, causing it to send terrifying data back to Earth, leaving scientists confused. Join us in today's video as we discuss the Voyager's space exploration journey so far and the strange data it's sending back to Earth. Since the Big Bang happened, scientists have been curious to find out what lies in the worlds beyond. And that has motivated the launch of several space probes, including the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. According to the official fact sheet, the Voyager 2 was actually the first spacecraft to launch, taking off from the NASA Kennedy Space Center on August 20, 1977. Voyager 1 launched 2 weeks later on the 5th of September the same year. But how did they swap positions? As siblings, both spacecraft actually had the same weight, about 720 kilograms, or the size of a subcompact car. They were both launched during a window of a special alignment of outer planets that creates a slingshot effect to catapult these spacecraft from one planet to another. However, they've had to travel on different trajectories and at varying speeds, and this allowed the Voyager 1 to overtake its twin ship on December 15, 1977. And since then, it has been our most trusted source for uncovering different information and mysteries about space. It was the first spaceship to cross the hemisphere. It was around 265 million kilometers away from our Earth in 1978 when it started its Jovian imaging mission, sending tons of images back to Earth. From January 1979, the Voyager 1 went on an impressive 100-hour stint where it took 3,750 pictures of Jupiter's rotation to create a time-lapse movie to showcase 10 rotations of the planet. In February 1979, it had crossed the Jovian moon system, and 1 month later, it discovered the tiny ring around Jupiter. In another first-of-its-kind event, Voyager 1 discovered two new moons called Thebe and Metis. Two course corrections would ensue to prepare it for this spacecraft for its flyby around Saturn and to avoid a possible collision with one of Saturn's moons, Titan. During its mission around Saturn, Voyager 1 also discovered four other moons, including Mimas, Enceladus, Tethys, Dione, and Rhea. Upon completion of the Saturn mission, scientists decided to end the Voyager planetary mission and send both the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 outside our solar system at a speed of 325 million miles every year. The new mission, tagged Voyager Interstellar Mission, officially began in January 1990. On the 14th of February 1990, at 6 billion kilometers away from the Sun, Voyager 1 took some of the most iconic pictures in history, showing the Sun and most of the planets. They are often called the Solar System Family Portrait, although Mercury and Mars cannot be seen in the photos for different reasons. The pictures were 60 altogether, taking the total number of pictures shot by Voyager 1 to 67,000. Eventually, the cameras on the spacecraft were turned off to save power and memory space ahead of its interstellar mission. Aside from Voyager 1 and Voyager 2, NASA has three other interstellar probe machines, including the Pioneer 10, Pioneer 11, and New Horizons. The Pioneer 10 was the farthest spaceship until Voyager 1 ran past it on the 17th of February 1998. With no other space probes in sight to catch up with, Voyager 1 travelled for another 14 years to reach the interstellar environment on August 25, 2012. But NASA kept the achievement under wraps until 2013. Fast forward to November 2018, the Voyager 2 crossed the heliopause into the interstellar world, meaning both space probe machines are officially outside our solar system. Currently, Voyager 1 is estimated to be 155 astronomical units, or 14.5 billion miles, away from Earth. Since it is crossed into the uncharted territory beyond our solar system, it has continued to fuel us with useful information that no other space probe missions have been able to reveal. the spacecraft has remained in good health for most part of its 45-year journey in space. However, scientists have recently noticed some strange inconsistencies in its performance. In recent times, Voyager 1 appears to be confused about the coordinates of its location and is now sending mysterious signals back to Earth. However, there's a terrifying twist to the whole situation. Normally, in the event that Voyager is lost in space, scientists have pre-programmed it to either go into safe mode or sound an alarm, but so far, it has not done so. And its antenna, which feeds data back to Earth, seems to be in perfect condition, except that the data it has been returning in recent times is questionable. The Interstellar Explorer is operating normally, receiving and executing commands from Earth, along with gathering and returning science data. But readouts from the probe's articulation and control system don't reflect what's actually happening on board, an official statement by NASA states. So what exactly is going on board? Each interstellar-bound spacecraft, including the Voyager 1 and 2, contains a special 12-inch diameter gold-plated disc with audio and video messages for a just-in-case scenario if extraterrestrial beings find the spacecraft. Some of the files stored in the disc include 35 sounds from Earth, 115 images of life, 90 minutes of Western music, and greetings from former US President Jimmy Carter and ex-UN Secretary General Kurt Waldheim. We should also mention that they're recorded in 55 languages. So if it was hijacked by aliens, they'll probably be trying to decipher the messages. However, scientists have been quick to debunk rumours that suggest that the spacecraft is now being controlled by aliens. The AACS, Attitude and Articulation Control Subsystem, is key to the operation of Voyager. For one, it keeps its antenna pointed at Earth at all times to enable scientists to receive data promptly. It also directs the orientation of the spaceship. At the moment, engineers monitoring the situation believe that the AACS is working as it should, and that adds more confusion to the mystery we have on our hands already. Also, none of the safety systems that were programmed to protect the spacecraft from threats have been triggered. A mystery like this is sort of par for the course at this stage of the Voyager mission, Susan Dodd, a project manager for Voyager 1 and 2, said in a statement. The spacecraft are both almost 45 years old, which is far beyond what the mission planners anticipated. In addition, Susan Dodd admits that the engineering team behind the spacecraft will face some big challenges if trying to rectify the issue with Voyager 1. Launching a rescue mission is virtually impossible due to the distance between us and the space probe. It is so far away that messages sent from Earth at the speed of light take nearly 21 hours to reach its current location, meaning a two-way communication between Earth and the spacecraft requires an average of 2 days. In another statement, NASA says, until the nature of the issue is better understood, the team cannot anticipate whether this might affect how long the spacecraft can collect and transmit science data. Nonetheless, Susan Dodd and the engineering team believe that the team will resolve it if it's something that can be repaired with the AACS. Maybe the solution will be found soon and Voyager can go back to its optimum best. But whatever its fate will be, we can be grateful as this legendary space probe already served its cause.